I don't know what's happening. This is the way. What's up, guys? It's the Iron Mandalorian, and welcome back to another vlog on my channel. I was at the gym again today, as you saw in those previous clips. I hope you enjoyed those. It took quite a bit of work for, especially that one with me jumping over that giant red mat. It took quite a bit of work to get that one done, but I did it, and I'm still alive, thankfully. Here's the news, though. I was there today. I'm still kind of tired, because I had to wake up really early this morning for that. But I had fun, and it was really great. Anyway, you guys are probably wondering about my new look. And yes, I know the jacket seems a little strange, I guess you could say, but that is not a hint to it being a Doctor Strange-themed outfit. No, it is not. It is actually Peter Quill's jacket, and some of you, or most of you, may know him as Star-Lord from Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy. And I gotta be honest, I love those movies so much. But I digress, of course, because I love Marvel so much. Anyway, this jacket is, yes, it is Peter Quill's, but it is not from one of the Guardians of the Galaxy movies. It's actually themed after the newest ride at Walt Disney World's Epcot, Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind. No, in case any of you are wondering, I have not been on that ride yet, and I am so mad about that. Excuse me, lost a little there. But you guys, that ride, it's almost impossible to get on right now because Disney's doing the virtual queue for it, and then you have to get really lucky to try and get a time for it, and it's just so much work. Like, it's just, well, I mean, it's not a lot complicated, but it's complicated enough that it's going to make it difficult to go on the ride when you're there. Anyway, sorry about that pause, you guys. I just had a, I like to call them brain farts, you know, who doesn't? You know, like, I'm having it, though, because, like I said, I'm really tired, you guys. Like, I woke up early this morning, well, early for me. I got up at 7:30 in the morning, and I understand, you know, for people who are public schooled, you know, or, you know, even people who have other jobs, you know, different jobs than what I do at the gym, you know, sure, they might have to get up earlier than that. But for me, 7:30 in the morning is early, and I do not like it, you guys. It's not pleasant, but the result is great. I love it so much. Here's the thing, though. The jacket is nice. It is very nice, and the reason I did not do this vlog sooner is because when I first ordered it, I ordered it in a large, because I wear an adult men's large in clothes. Like, that's just me. I forgot, though, that Disney's clothes sizes run small. Yes, they run small. And it's not just because of the size of this jacket, or not size of this jacket, whoops. It's the style of the jacket, I should be saying, not size, style. Style of this jacket is, it's just different. It's a kind of a short fit, I guess you could say, that's what I'm saying anyway. It's a short fit because that's, I guess, just the style of jacket that Star-Lord wears. And honestly, you know, I had to return my large because even though it's a short fit, it was still too small for me because the clothes sizes at Disney run small, at least with this type of material. Because this is a leather jacket, you guys. Like, it feels nice. This is authentic. But it's just because it's leather, and the material, and the style, it's just, it fits short. So, we returned it, got me a new one, and I got an extra large, because the extra large was hopefully the right size to get. And it was, and wouldn't you know it, I'm wearing it right now. It's really nice, though, guys. Like, I like it a lot. It's comfortable, but I can't wear it right now, because even though I don't live in Florida, it's still warm here. So yeah, I mean, it's not time for this jacket yet, but I'm just wearing it. Okay, guys, quick thing. I just had a very strange experience. And no, that is not a Doctor Strange reference. I was sitting here, and all of a sudden, my door just moved on its own. I got it locked so nobody disturbs me while I'm vlogging. And it just moved. on its own, and it wiggled, and it almost opened all the way. It was really weird, and a little creepy. And my sister and I have this running joke with some of our friends here, that we say there is a nice ghost, mind you, and we call him Joe. And Joe likes to pull pranks on us, and he first started doing this when my sister started hearing booming noises in my room coming from my closet, because my room is right next to hers, so she can hear it, like, right from the other side of the wall. Again, I digress. But anyway, like, the door just moved on its own, and I looked. I have dogs and cats, and neither of them were playing at the door. So I don't know what that was about, but I think Joe's trying to interrupt me while I'm vlogging, and if he is, I hope it's not for too much longer, because I'd like to, you know, be able to do this. Anyway, though, I digressed again. Anyway, the jacket. It's, like I said, it fits small, but I got the extra large, and it works now. And it's too warm to wear it outside now, but it's getting closer to September, so, you know, now that it's the month of August. Man, 2022 has been going fast, you guys. Like, it's crazy for me. Like, I don't understand it. But anyway, September's coming right around the corner, and this jacket will soon be in style for, you know, the weather, and I'll be able to wear it outside of the house, you know, not just on the vlog for you guys. Anyway, though, like, I love the jacket, like I said, but the one thing I don't understand is this thing right here. I have no idea what this is, and I've tried looking it up, and I'm guessing it's like a containment unit on the jacket sleeve. I'm not sure. Maybe they'll explain on the ride when I hopefully go to Disney World in September. I told you guys about that already, and I hope you're excited for me to vlog that. I'm certainly excited to vlog it, because when I went in June, that's when I think my vlogs really started taking off, and I loved doing every minute of that. It was so fun. But I did not just come here to talk to you guys about my jacket and my upcoming Disney trip and the weather. I also came here to tell you about the new segment of my vlogs, like this new series I'm going to try and do. I hope I can do this. If not, then today will be the only one. So, in those gym clips that I had at the beginning of this vlog, as you know, one of them was me running and leaping a tremendous bound over that, we call it the resi, the giant red mat. We call it the resi at the gym. That's the technical term for it. You know, it's fun. You know, we use it for all kind of different stuff when we're at the gym, you know, mainly for practicing harder skills just so we have a cushier landing, you know, so we don't hurt ourselves because, you know, let's be honest. Gymnastics is a tough sport. Tumbling, trampoline, beam, you know, you name it. It's crazy. But to do a lot of the stuff we do in the gym, like leaping over the resi like that, it takes a tremendous amount of courage. And courage is something that you will need pretty much every single day of your life in this world, especially if you do what I do at the gym. And I haven't shown you guys me tumbling yet, but I'm hoping to get that into one of my vlogs soon, because I got a skill already set up that I'm going to do for you guys. But I digress, again. The reason I bring up courage is because not only do I need courage, but, you know, other people need courage too, even fictional characters. Why do I mention fictional characters, and why am I wearing a Marvel-themed jacket right now? I will tell you. Think really hard. What Marvel superhero or villain has not needed courage in their time in any of the movies or shows they've been in? Can't think of any? Neither can I. Because they all need it. You know, sometimes the villains get a little cocky and, you know, let's face it, Iron Man thinks he knows everything. But even still, those people still need the courage. One person, one superhero in Marvel who I recognize mostly who needs courage is Spider-Man. This guy, right here, for those of you who don't know him. Now, this is another thing I got from Disney. He's pretty cool. He is the Spider-Man action figure from Spider-Man No Way Home, Marvel's most recent Spider-Man movie. If you have not seen that movie yet, shame on you. You have to see it. It is like, oh, he fell over. It is like one of Marvel's greatest Spider-Man movies ever, okay? Like, it's great. And it's like one of the official references to the multiverse. But the reason I use this Spider-Man as an example from Spider-Man No Way Home is because spoiler alert for any of you who haven't seen this movie yet. Peter Parker, who is Spider-Man, obviously you're going to have to know that. Even if you haven't seen Marvel movies, like, you should know that. It's general knowledge. Peter Parker, at the end of the movie, has to summon as much courage as he possibly can and make one of the hardest decisions of his life. The villains coming through the multiverse to his universe to fight him all know his identity, and there is no way to send them back or stop them from getting there without erasing everybody's knowledge of Peter Parker. Thankfully, everybody knows Spider-Man, but everybody in the world will forget who Peter Parker is. Even his friends and even his loved ones. Like, he has a girlfriend and a best friend in his life, and they will not remember him whatsoever. They'll know Spider-Man, but they will have no recollection of Peter Parker. I mean, talk about a fresh start, am I right? But it's not the best way to get a fresh start. You know, you gotta have... If I were in Peter's shoes, I would have to summon as much of my courage as possible, maybe even all of it. Now, that makes me think, though, and I hope it makes you guys think, too. Who else needed to summon a lot of courage for a big battle or big decision? Well, the first person who comes to my mind is a character in the Bible. You may know him as David, from the story of David and Goliath. Goliath was a giant Philistine, for those of you who don't know. And he came to attack the Israelites. So yeah, Goliath attacked the Israelites. Well, he didn't attack them exactly. He came down from the Philistine camp and threatened them. But he made them a deal, though. He said that they should send out their strongest warriors, if I remember correctly, to try and battle him. And if they beat him, to put it delicately, the Philistines would be the Israelites' slaves or servants. But everybody who saw Goliath, who was like, I don't even know how tall he was, I can't remember. He's taller than me, and I'm almost 6 feet. He was a giant, let's just put it that way. And I'm not talking like, I don't think he was like as big as Willy from Mickey and the Beanstalk, if you've seen that Disney short. But, you know, he was average for a real-life giant, I would think. I hope he's average. But yeah, everybody in the Israelite camp saw him and fled. Like, nobody wanted to fight him. So, David wanted to take a swing at it. Literally, take a swing at it. Because when David went to meet Goliath, first, Goliath laughed in his face. Because, as, you know, handsome as David was, as the Bible says, he was the youngest brother. He was the youngest amongst any of them. So he looked weak, and it didn't look like he could do much of anything. But he had courage and faith in God that he would be led to victory, basically. But he knew that no matter the outcome, you know, this is at least what I think, he knew no matter the outcome, he would have God on his side. Now, here's what I think about that. As a Christian, I think that's great. You know, that's exactly what a Christian mind should be. You always have God on your side, no matter what. Here's the thing, though. When I say literally took a swing, it's true. David went into battle with no armor, no sword, no shield, nothing. He went into battle with 5 smooth stones and a sling. That's right. 5 smooth stones and a sling. Try saying that 5 times fast. 5 smooth stones. I can't even say it once. He went to battle with those things. And again, took a swing at Goliath, and he launched a stone right to Goliath's forehead. Basically, you take this hat. Imagine this hat is a stone, and my head is huge. The stone goes right into the forehead. All right, right smack dab in the middle of the forehead. It even says that in the Bible. It's specific. Center of the forehead. And the stone sunk into Goliath's forehead. That's what happened. And Goliath fell. But, you know, there's a moral behind that story. At least the moral that sticks out to me is you want to have courage and faith in God no matter what. And like I said before, that clip of me at the gym jumping over the resi, I knew I could do it. I knew I could do it because I've been doing gymnastics and tumbling, trampoline. I've been doing all that stuff for a long time. But, you know, when I jumped over that resi, that's more of a parkour skill, or ninja, as we call it at the gym. So, parkour and ninja makes me think of Spider-Man. Spider-Man in Spider-Man No Way Home needed a lot of courage to erase himself, Peter Parker, that is, from everybody's memories in the world. And, you know, David needed a lot of courage and faith to defeat Goliath. At least that's what I think, you know? Even if, I don't think David, being the youngest among the group of Israelites, went up to Goliath and said, I am the best of the best, and I don't need courage or faith or anything like that to beat you. No. He was, I would think he was more modest about it. The Bible doesn't say anything about him being modest, but in my opinion, if I were in David's shoes, I would probably be the same way. I'd be modest about it, and I would think, you know, I'm going to have faith and courage no matter the outcome. And that's just how we got to go through life. So yeah, that's my new segment. If you haven't figured it out, my new series that I'm going to try and do, unless today is the only one that I do it in, is I'm going to try and give a bit of a Bible/life lesson in my vlogs. And it's, of course, going to include, as examples, biblical characters and Marvel or Star Wars characters, maybe even DC characters or Disney. You know, you never know. I mean, Disney owns Marvel and Star Wars now, so it kind of falls into that category. But, you know, that's what I'm going to do now, and I hope you guys enjoy it because I enjoy talking about my faith and what I believe in because, you know, I feel like we kind of need that in the world right now, and I hope that these vlogs bring you joy in your life. And maybe they'll help you through some problems. You never know, you know? But today's Bible life lesson was on courage and having faith no matter what. Because, you know, we all need that. Anyway, coming off of that, I hope you enjoyed it. And just a little update. Next weekend, I am going to be suffering, to put it delicately, suffering. But hopefully still having a good time because my sister is going to have one of her friends over to my house again, or to our house, I should say, for a sleepover. But it's not just going to be one night. It's going to be the whole weekend. But I don't know much how much vlogging I'll be doing next weekend because of that. But, you know, who knows? We'll see what happens. But for now, I hope you enjoyed this vlog. If you enjoyed it, please like the vlog and check out some of my other vlogs because, honestly, in my opinion, I think they're great. And that is me not being modest, by the way. But yeah, you know, if you enjoyed this vlog, please like the vlog and check out some of my other ones. I got some other biblical ones, mainly the Summerfest ones because I went to see Skillet and For King and Country, who are both Christian-related bands. But I digress again. I'll let you check those out for yourself. So, for now, I will say I hope you enjoyed the vlog, and until next time, I'll see you real soon. Bye, guys.